The best thing about a rescue dog is they fucking come correct. They know what "you want to go back" means.
They're called rag dolls because, like, I don't know you, ma'am, but if you came to my house, you just scoop that cat up. They wouldn't get nervous. Who's this crazy lady? They wouldn't. They just, anybody could just pick one of those cats up and put it on their shoulder, and they just go limp. Because I have a seven-year-old daughter. My daughter just scoops that cat up like a sandbag in a CrossFit class. Like, she's barely got this fucking cat. And they just limp. Purring away, so happy to be touched. They have almost no instincts. Almost. Almost! Because those little fuckers are sitting in front of the window. And they see a squirrel across the street. Their eyes lock on that squirrel, and they start making these involuntary mouth noises like... You ever see your cat do that? It's so fucking creepy. They don't even know you're there. You get right next to them like, what the fuck are you doing, man? I don't even look at you. I've had that cat since it was a baby. It's never been outside. Three-year-old cat, never been outside. And he sees those squirrels across the street and he's like, I remember. I remember the old way. How the fuck does that DNA get into that cat? He's not looking at that squirrel like, that's my little friend across the street. I would like to meet him. No, it's like, ah, your neck is right there. That's crazy. That's some crazy murderous DNA. That's like if you had a science experiment where you had a man in captivity and you never showed him a woman ever until he was full grown. And then you show him a naked one through prison glass. And as soon as he sees her, he goes, "Done the fuck! Done the fucking fuck!" Dudes come over with clipboards. How do you know? How do you know what to do? I know what to know, bro! I know when it's fuck time! It's fucking... That's what it's like for that cat! How the fuck's that cat know what to do? Explain that to me, science. Cats kill everything they can. Dogs will keep it together. Like, if you have a good dog will keep it together. Like, you could have a pet dog and a pet hamster. And that pet hamster, if you got a good dog, that pet hamster could live a long life. If you got a pet cat and a pet hamster, that hamster's got an hour to live. And that's just because your cat's gonna torture it for 59 minutes. That poor little fucker's like, oh, I think he's done. Finally, it's gonna let me get away and I'm just gonna be free. And the cat's like, not today, motherfucker. Not today. You just sit the fuck down. It's what they do. You can't feed them apples. It's what they do. Dogs care. You could put a hamster on the floor in a room with a good dog. Good dog. Look at you, look at the hamster. Look at you, look at the hamster. Like, can I fuck him up? No, that's Mr. Fluffers. Mr. Fluffers is the newest member of our family. The dogs just start calculating, like, okay. I like free food. These people are nice to me, okay. That's a fucking rat, dude. That's a rat. Okay. Family. Yeah, family. You can tell, though, when that dog's not totally on board, you just get a little too close to that hamster. Like, ooh, I was gonna fuck you up. But a cat, you don't have a chance. Cats, they would make exorcist noises. If you try to hold your cat in a room with a hamster, your cat starts going, wow, 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 wow. This is letting you know, bitch, I'm about to claw your fucking eyes out. You're never gonna see your kids again. They don't care how long you've been feeding them. They don't care about your history of free massages. There's a rat on the floor. If you let me go, I can kill the rat. Wow. And people keep those things as pets. That's what's so fucked up. Imagine if your kid did that. If you had a kid that you couldn't have in a room with something smaller than him, he's like, gotta kill mommy. Murder! Kill! Like, Junior, sit down.
No! Fuck you! Death!
Well, we just can't have a pet cat because Junior breaks the cat's neck. He's crazy. I don't know what to do.
We just accept the fact this fucking cat's a murderer.
Can't feed that thing cranberries, you crazy bitch. There you go. You're the monster. Dogs feel bad when they kill things too, if you're mad. Like if your dog kills a hamster, like, how could you? Like, ooh, how could I? Shit! Did I do that? Ah! Damn it! I am so disappointed in you.
I'm disappointed in myself. Oh, I'm sorry. No!
I walked to you sideways. I fucked up, dude. I'm fucking. Seriously?
But your cat doesn't feel remotely bad. Your cat kills something, you're like, how could you? He's like, bitch, you know me. Walk away slow with his tail in the air so you can see his asshole. They don't care. You scream at him. You're a monster. They pull their ears back like, why are you so loud? And just lie down right in front of you and lick their own dick.
How about you just shut the fuck up while I lick my dick?
They don't care. They don't care about you. Cats know when you're high, too. They seem to know. You're vulnerable. Dogs don't have a clue. You come home, you're high, your dog's like, you're extra friendly today. If I'm watching Black Mirror at 1 o'clock in the morning, my cat will like sit down next to me and be like, you know you're gonna die, right?
I have a dog. I got a dog like 4 months before I broke up with my boyfriend because I just felt maybe that's where it was headed. And I was like, I can't handle a breakup. I get too sad. I'm going to need something on retainer that will give me unconditional love, like maybe go down on me. I'm not going to like train him to do it, you know? I'm not going to be like, do it, Luigi. Like, I'm not going to like, no. I don't know. If I woke up and it was happening, I might not fight it off. I don't know. And of course, I would not be like, oh, my dog's going down on me. That wouldn't, like, do it for me. I would try to maybe, like, fantasize about, like a famous dog, like a Lassie or, like, a Eddie from Frasier. Girls, right? Hall pass. No, it's a disgusting thought. I'm sorry to even bring it up, that your dog would, you know, go down on you. It's gross. Here's why I thought of it. It's because it almost happened. Almost. Okay, I sleep with my dog. He sleeps under the covers, and I sleep naked. And I'm not saying that to be like, I sleep naked. Like, I'm not trying to be hot about it. Like, Santa naked. Like, I don't. There's nothing hot about me sleeping naked. It's only because I break out in, like, violent night sweats. So I have to save some laundry time for me. I'm always withdrawing from Zoloft because I forget to take it. So I'm just, like, waking up in puddles. It's disgusting. So my dog sleeps, and one night he was going under the covers to, like, go to bed, and he just nicked it with his nose. Like a very, like, just a whoop, like a just a brush, grazed it. And of course, I was like, no, you know, because he had been a bad dog that day. I'm not going to reward that kind of behavior. You know, no, thank you, dog owners, you know, and... No, I was just, you can't do it, obviously. And I was like, no, but he wanted it so bad. Like, you're uncomfortable, but you, it's okay. He was like, he was very interested, wanted more. And so your dog would too, your dog wants to go down on you so badly. And that's the hard part. You can't let him do it. It would be the ultimate treat for them. And I know you're like, wait, no, it wouldn't, but think about it. Your dog is psyched to eat shit off the sidewalk. Like, he would love to lick on your sweet, sweet puss. He just would. It would be awesome for him. Some of you are still like, no, not my dog. He wouldn't do it. He's too proud. No, he would. Dogs love crotches. They're trying to get in there constantly. It's my favorite thing when a dog smells another person, and the person always, like, when the dog smells them, they go, oh, he must smell my dog. And I'm like, oh, really? Just, like, right here is your dog. Just, oh, he smells Tanner. Is that what you call your sack? Because that's, he's honing in on that, those right balls. It's not your dog. It's Misty. But it is, it's a disgusting thought. And here's the thing. It's like, even if that was something you didn't have a problem doing, like, why would you do it? As a woman, I'm like, would your dog be good at eating pussy? Like, no. Have you watched your dog eat food? Like, my dog eats wet food. The second I put it on the ground, like, he's just rubbing his face in it, pushing all around the kitchen. I can't have that style going on down there anymore. Like, that was college for me, where I was just like, you know what? I'm gonna let him figure it out. We're all learning. I can't just, I need focus. Like, I need you to have, like, a headlamp on and, like one of those jewelers, like, things. I don't even know what they're called. I need that kind of, like, so if my dog was just going to, I'd be like, can you use your paw or something? Like, I just feel like it would just be a waste of peanut butter is what I'm saying ultimately, because I buy the good shit with the oil on top. It's organic. Choosy dog owners. No, I'm going back to Jif though. Sorry, Luigi. No, I don't blame my dog for wanting it, honestly. And this is the last thing I'll say about it is that I promise. It is tempting because I don't have a landing strip, but I do have a begging strip, and it's like.
And when I was younger, I used to think like that. Eh? I'm just fucking party tonight every fucking day. Go eat a taco later. You get older, man, you don't think like that no more, man. You're too old at the club. You're dancing. Fuck, eh? I wonder if my dog is thinking about me. He was so sad when I left. He gets sad when he hears the keys. For real, I start thinking about my dog and shit. I'm like, fuck, okay. What are you thinking about, bro? I don't know, man. We should stop and buy my dog a hot dog, bro. He's fucking sad right now. He probably still asleep by the door. You love your dog, man. Sometimes you love your dog more than your kids. Dad, are you gonna be off the computer? Shut up, mijo, trying to find a costume for the dog. Halloween's coming, you know, he weighs 90 pounds. For real, man. I didn't even buy my dog like at a pet store, man. I found that fool at Walmart. The parking lot at Walmart, fucking redneck guy with a box. It's funny, man. When I was a little boy, we had a dog, but shit. We couldn't keep him no more. And we don't know nothing about no shelters. You know, Mexicans, immigrants, we don't know nothing about shelters for animals. We know there's some for humans, but not for animals. It was so sad. My dad took the dog to the park and fuck him, left him there. That fucking dog made it home before him. With two other dogs talking shit. Rah, 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 rah. Rawr, 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 rawr. It's funny when you can't really take your dog, my dog, to a dog park because he's out of control, you know. He's like a rescue dog, so he came with a heroin problem, you know. He barked like this. He fucking. Rawr, 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 rawr. He had like one eye. Rawr, 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 rawr. I feel like nightmares at night and shit. He's running. Fucking fucked up, man. The best thing about a rescue dog is they fucking come correct. They know not to fuck around. They know what you want to go back means. You better shut up. You want to go back? No. No. If you're gonna have a dog, make sure you have money for dog fucking food. Make sure you have money to take the dog to the fucking hospital because they fucking get sick. I remember my dog got sick when we were little and it cost $200 to fucking fix the dog. And my dad said, mijo, $200? Shit, that's more than our rent. He better get better, mijo. The dog was trying to pretend he wasn't sick. We never gave him dog food. He will eat Mexican food or human food. Like, if I had diarrhea, my dog would die. Who gave him chilaquiles?